Hello friends, welcome to my channel Pediatrics and Life Tips. Today I will talk about Klippel-Feil syndrome and the Sprengel's deformity. This is a young child with Klippel-Feil syndrome and Sprengel deformity. I will discuss two cases. Case number one is a 2-year-old boy presented in OPD as his parents were worried that there is difficulty in moving his neck sideways. He is otherwise active and developmentally normal. Now, question number one for this scenario is, what is the diagnosis? And question number two is, give other associated findings in this condition. The diagnosis is Klippel-Feil syndrome, and the other associated findings in this condition are occipito-cervical synostosis, Sprengel's deformity, scoliosis, genito-urinary abnormalities, sensorineural hearing loss, and congenital heart defects. Now, second case is a picture test, and the questions are, name the three clinical findings in the pictures. What specific deformity is shown in the second picture? What is the diagnosis? What systemic complications can occur? Now, answer number one is short neck, low hairline, torticollis, and neck webbing. Answer number two is Sprengel's deformity. Answer number three is Klippel-Feil syndrome. And answer number four is scoliosis, sensory neural hearing loss, genitourinary problems, cardiovascular anomalies, and neurological problems. Now I will discuss Klippel-Feil syndrome and Sprengel deformity in detail. The classic triad of Klippel-Feil syndrome include low posterior hairline, short neck, and decreased cervical range of motion. But all these three findings are present only in less than 50% of the patient. Klippel-Feil syndrome is a congenital fusion of one or more cervical segments at the craniocervical junction or in the subaxial spine. It is often associated with other congenital anomalies of the cervical spine and other organ systems. Incidence of Klippel-Feil syndrome is about 1:40,000 to 42,000 births. Now I will discuss the classification of Klippel-Feil syndrome. Type 1 is autosomal recessive and it is due to fusion at C1 with or without a more caudal fusion level, and this is associated with severe anomalies. Type 2 is autosomal dominant and it is due to fusion of C2 and C3 with or without a more caudal fusion. Type 3 may be autosomal dominant or autosomal recessive, and it is the isolated fusion caudal to C1 and C2 or C3. Now the type 4 is X-linked dominant, and it is synonymous with Wilder-Wernicke syndrome or the Duane anomaly. The Wilder-Wernicke syndrome is the congenital cervical synostosis associated with hearing loss, and Duane anomaly is the congenital rare type of strabismus. Now, associated findings in Klippel-Feil syndrome include, in the cervical spine, there may be occipito-cervical synostosis, odontoid abnormalities, and basilar impression. There may be Sprengel deformity, which is the congenital elevation of the scapula. In this, the child has limited shoulder abduction. Other findings may be congenital scoliosis, genitourinary abnormalities in the form of double collecting system, renal aplasia, or horseshoe-shaped kidney. There may be sensory neural hearing loss or congenital heart defects. Now, in this picture and the radiograph, you can appreciate the Sprengel deformity, which is the congenital elevation of the scapula. Now, there are certain syndromes which have cervical spine anomalies of Klippel-Feil syndrome, and these include Golden Heart syndrome, Mohr syndrome, Vectral syndrome, and Fetal Alcohol syndrome. Now I will discuss the clinical presentation of Klippel-Feil syndrome. It is present at birth but usually become clinically apparent until second or third decade. Patient present with pain, loss of motion or neurological symptoms. Patient is at risk for the development of hypermobility and instability, especially at motion segments adjacent to the fused vertebrae. It may present with weakness or clumsiness. On physical examination, the child may have myelopathy or radiculopathy signs. Myelopathy is the spinal cord compression. This may result from stenosis or instability. In this, upper motor neuron signs are positive, that is hyperreflexia, Babinski sign, and sustained glonus. Radiculopathy is the nerve root compression, and this may result from stenosis. In this, there is weakness in the muscle or decreased sensation in the dermatomes depending upon the nerve root involved. For diagnosis of Klippel field syndrome, X-ray cervical spine should be done. Anteroposterior view, lateral view in flexion and extension of the neck and oblique views are necessary. And the characteristic finding is the fusion of two or more vertebrae. Thoracic and lumbosacral spine radiograph should also be done because there may be associated anomalies. CT scan and MRI of the spine is also necessary because it accurately characterizes the bony anomalies and identify any coexisting neural pathology. Other supportive tests are renal ultrasound, echocardiography, audiometry, and other tests to find the anomalies. Now I will discuss the treatment of Klippel field syndrome. In this, pain is usually controlled by activity restriction or intermittent immobilization. Now, the candidates for surgical treatment include those who are chronically symptomatic, those who have instability with positive neurological symptoms or findings, and those who are at increased risk for neurologic deterioration. Now, the operative interventions include decompression of nerve root, decompression of spinal cord, spinal fusion to address spinal instability or stabilization for progressive cervicothoracic scoliosis. Thanks for watching this video. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel.